Nate and I and our family have been coming to the beach for Thanksgiving for the last 35 years. And what you see here wasn't here. What was here 35 years ago were just some of the scrub trees, the dunes, and the beach. And then out there was a gravel road. I could have bought a lot right here for $1,000. If I wanted to buy it on the other side of the gravel road, it would have been $500. If I want to buy that same lot today, it's going to cost me $3 million. And then I'm going to spend another $6 million to put a house like this on it. This is a direct example of how our society is growing. This, if you put the price of this against the NASDAQ or the S&P market, you'll get a direct parallel. That is what's going to happen as we move into Web 3.0. Web 1.0 and Web 2.0 created this. Now you got to get prepared for what's going to happen next.
Best of Us Investors presents Kerry Griegmeier.
Web 1.0 was basically search. It was Google's ability to help us find anything and everything that we wanted on the internet, and then to send email. Web 2.0 introduced us to e-commerce, and then what we're doing right here. Without Web 1.0 and Web 2.0, I could not be talking to you like this today. And this would not exist, because the money that was generated from Web 1.0 and 2.0 created this. That's what took that lot from $1,000 to over $3 million in the same period of time. That's all well and good, and I wish back in 1985 I had bought a lot down here and built a house on it, and I'd have now probably a $15 million property, but I didn't. So the question is, what's going to happen next, and how can I position myself to profit off of it? That's Web 3.0. Now, is interest rates and inflation going to stop it? No, it will slow it down, much as the dot-com bubble and the subprime crisis slowed down the straight rocket up. But this property will get worth more, and the property down the beach in Mexico Beach that was hit by a hurricane about 4 years ago will escalate in price, and the people that make the money off of Web 3.0 will go down there and buy a $1 million lot, and it will turn into a $10 million lot. The same is going to happen within the stock market. What we need to do as investors is anticipate Web 3.0. What is it going to look like? How is it going to affect us? And who are the companies that are going to facilitate it? Well, it's going to be all about data. Who owns the data? We know that. That's Microsoft, that's Amazon, that's Google, that's Apple. They own the data. Web 3.0 is all going to be about refining that data and making that data profitable to you and I. Yeah, through blockchain and through Web 3.0, our data is going to become ours. If you go to a website today, you will see a little box show up, and it will ask you about your cookies. Are you going to give them your cookies, or are you going to put restrictions on them? That is Web 3.0 coming your way, because eventually you will have an agent, and that agent will represent you on that website, and that you will negotiate what your cookies are worth, and you will get a check from Amazon, Google, Apple, Microsoft every year for the or every month for the use of your data. That's Web 3.0. How is that possible? Through blockchain. Okay? Blockchain is basically going to give you ownership of everything that you have and anything that is worth. And then people will bid on what you own. Give you an example. Last night we went to a dinner, and a young couple brought their daughter, 3 years old, and that young daughter entertained everybody with dancing and singing and playing, goofing around for 2 hours. That I went to her father and I said, Stu, I'd like to buy 10% ownership in your daughter, Charlie. He says, what are you talking about? I says, you've got the next Taylor Swift on your hands right there. And I'd like to own 10% of her future earnings. And I'll help you educate her and I'll help you get her to the position where she can be the next Taylor Swift. He says, you must be crazy. I said, no, I'm not, Stuart. I'll invest in your daughter's education and her development if we can point her towards becoming the next Taylor Swift. Well, Charlie kept on entertaining. Before the end of the day, he came over and said, the price has gone up. I'll give you 25%. And then he threw a number at me. We both laughed. And what I knew was what we just talked about is going to happen. Because the thing that has made all of this possible here is data. The data that Jeff Bezos owns, the data that Google owns, the data that Tim Cook owns on you and I. Without that, none of this would happen. And none of what is going to happen next would happen. So what do we do as investors? We recognize that we had an event called the Corona Crisis, and our reaction here in the United States was to increase our money supply by 40%, and that created an abundance of money. At the same time, the virus shut down the supply chain. So that created a shortage of goods. So when you got more money than goods, you get inflation. Once you work through it, though, it all settles down and things return to reality. Now, the other equation that you need to factor in here is whenever things go crazy, whenever prices get crazy and people start behaving crazy, we overvalue assets. That happened in the dot-com bubble. That happened in the subprime crisis. And it now has happened here. So we have things like the cryptocurrency crash. We have things like Tesla going skyrocketing and making young billionaires, and then it coming crashing down. We saw the same thing with ARK Invest and Kathy Woods. So we have to work through those things. But what you and I need to do is figure out what 3.0 is going to look like, how they're going to empower us to own our data and profit off it, how we are going to get some of that money that Elon Musk and Jeff Bezos now holds in their coffers into our pockets, because that's what's fair. That's what's fair. If they're selling advertising, or if they're selling goods, or if they're selling cars off of our data, then they need to pay us for it. And through 3.0, Web 3.0, that will happen. Now, the other thing you need to recognize, as a result of the coronavirus, something else very important happened. It would have happened anyway, and that is health cure is going to replace health care. Right now, if you get cancer, we care for you. We bombard your body with chemotherapy and hope that we kill it. In the future, though, what we'll do is go and take it out of your body. That is because it's a mutation. It's something you inherited in your body, and it's a fallacy with science, and that science has been driven through genome sequencing, genome editing, which has been accelerated as a result of the corona crisis. We are going to be able to take those diseases out of our body. Once we have that, there are some stocks, just like this lot that would have sold for $1,000 back in 1985, there are some stocks right now selling for $2.50 that are going to be worth $2,500 a share. They may even be worth $25,000 a share. What would you pay to have cancer taken out of your body, heart disease, Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, out of your family bloodline? What would you pay? Would the insurance companies pay for that so they don't have to pay for the health care that the disease brings? Of course they would. So that's what's in the future. You need to look at this land behind me here and see it's scrub and it's worth nothing. And that's what it was worth in 1985. But today, those scrub trees are worth millions of dollars because someone like you and I want to build a house on it like this. Okay? And then what's crazy is someone in the next 15 years will want to tear our house down and build a more beautiful home, because that's what's happening to our society. That's what's happening to our investments. And you are right now, this moment, and sitting in the best opportunity, investment opportunity in a lifetime, because Amazon is 25-30% off. So is Google. So is Apple. And these are the, and Microsoft. And these are the companies that are going to take us into Web 3.0. Google it. Start reading about it. Talk to your friends about it. Sit down and coffee with them this next week and say, hey, what do you know about Web 3.0? What do you know about blockchain? What do you know about me getting paid for the use of my data from Jeff Bezos, from Google, from Apple, from Amazon? What do you know about that? And watch their eyes light up. Or watch them fall asleep and say, you must be crazy. Well, I am crazy because I read. I was with a gentleman last night and he was telling me, I said, when is the last time you read a nonfiction book? And he sat and he thought and he thought and he says, I can't remember. I said, I read a nonfiction book every month. I subscribe to Audible. In fact, I'll put a link down here where you can get a free month of a free book from Audible. And he said, yeah, but when do you have time to read? I said, when I go on my 2.5 mile walk 3 times a week. I put earbuds in, I put my phone, I put my Audible on my phone, and I learn. And if I will educate myself, if I will keep learning, I'm 78 years old, if I will keep learning and keep walking so that I live longer, I'll come out on top. I'm building a business. I'm building a business. I would not be here today if it were not for Web 2.0. Just imagine what I'm going to be able to do with Web 3.0. If you'd like to come on this ride with me, if you'd like to learn from me, if you'd like to profit and build your Web 3.0 business, subscribe, then join our tribe and come to our Friday stock meetings where we trade ideas, where we explore the future rather than just sit back and watch it go by us. I watch this thing turn from a desolate gravel road into paradise. And I come every year now for 35 years and then watch this happen and participate in it. I invite you to join me next year. Next Thanksgiving, I'll be here. I'll probably be sitting right here in this chair shooting another video. I'll talk to you again tomorrow.